program, John Nelson. And John, tonight's two coaches have coached 56 years for their respective schools. If you add them together, and you had spent some time with them this week.
Yeah, Dean Hargis was there for Alan Chadwick 9 years as an offensive coordinator before he took the helm. And you're talking about a lot of history as we go inside the matchup.
New coaches, 552 wins. Marist's Alan Chadwick has never had a losing season and is 8 wins away from 300. His first year was 1985. Southwest DeKalb's Buck Godfrey has had one losing season in his 29 seasons with the Panthers, and it took the playoffs for that to happen. Total wins, 260 and counting, and each obviously respects the other.
When I hear the name Alan Chadwick, I think of a guy who was well prepared, always a great competitor, and does well by his kids.
When I think of Coach Godfrey, I think he's an excellent coach. He's been around forever. He's had a number of players come through there. They've been great players. They've gone on to play college football as well as in the NFL. They've got a great tradition. You think about Southwest DeKalb, one of the first things you think about is the band and the amount of excitement and enthusiasm their fans and their support base brings to their ball game.
To hear these two talk about their time on the sidelines in charge, the game, yeah, it's changed, but at the same time, in some places it hasn't.
There's nothing changed in high school football except for some coaches believe in the fast break version, which we call basketball, throwing the ball all the time. The kids are the same, just parents change.
Well, I think offensively it's changed a great deal. People are more spreading the field a lot more. The coaching aspect of it has improved a great deal. Coaches are going to clinics. They're finding more ways to exploit offensive packages and their personnel. Defensively, you're seeing more teams that have multiple defenses. They go from a 3-5 to a 5-3 to a 60 to a 40, you know, all the different fronts. So you got to be prepared for that.
You're talking about these two coaches, one just shy of 70, one just shy of 60, and they just keep on humming.
John, thanks so much. Time now to check out scores from around the state on the Georgia EMC scoreboard, so let's check that out right now. Kell and Paulding, East Paulding was leading that game big, 17-0. Now it's 20-0 at the half. Walton over Roswell, 24-0 in the second quarter. South Gwinnett and Central Gwinnett, no score at the Georgia Dome. Hillgrove leads South Cobb, 20-0. Elsewhere, it is Allatoona trailing Dalton by a touchdown. It is Whitewater over Harris County, 7-0. Westlake and Melmel King all tied up 14-14. Milton leads Lassiter, 17-14 that game at the half. North Gwinnett leads Collins Hill by 10 at the half. And Warner Robins over Colquitt County, 10-6 at halftime. That game you can watch on gbb.org/sports. Well, now it's time for our Aetna Wellness Champion. High school sports and physical fitness go hand in hand. Right now we welcome in Scott Mandy, the strength and conditioning coach here at Marist High School. Coach, what are you guys at Marist School doing to help promote physical fitness for your students?
At Marist, we have a wide array of physical education programs, such as body conditioning, lifeguarding, aerobics, and just your general PE classes that promote physical education 4 days a week.
What's one thing that you would suggest, you know, that youngsters do in order to, you know, be physically fit and have a happier, healthier lifestyle?
The biggest thing I would say is to have a commitment. Be committed to whatever it is your goals. And I think once you have a commitment to something, Marist and programs will help you achieve those.
Well, listen, we appreciate you coming on with us, and good luck with the program.
Thank you very much.
All right. That's Mandy, the Aetna Wellness Champion. And now it's time to check in with Chrissy Warlow, our meteorologist, to see what the weather's going to be like for the second half and the drive home. Chrissy?
Thanks, Mark. We'll get back with Southwest DeKalb at Marist in just a moment. But first, we're looking at 65 degrees. It is cloudy, cool, and breezy out here. In fact, I had to put on my jacket. And as we go into the rest of halftime, fourth quarter, and overnight into tomorrow, we're seeing that we'll be at 65 for halftime, 59 for the fourth quarter, cool and breezy cool and breezy conditions will stick around as we go into Saturday, with the clouds sticking around, a little bit of drizzle, wind out of the east-northeast, 5 to 10 miles per hour. So it is cold out here, but it's perfect for some football, Mark.
Chrissy, thanks so much. We're getting ready to kick off the second half from Hugh Spaulding Stadium right here at the Marist School as they get ready to take on Southwest DeKalb for the final 24 minutes of action. But before we get to the action, we want to tell you how a way you can show your appreciation of GPB's high school football. All you have to do is text a $10 donation to GPB to help keep programming like this on the air. All you have to do is text the letters GPB to the number 85944 and be sure to reply yes. Message and data rates may apply. Well, we're getting ready for that second half. It's time now to send it to Gil. Dave and Trey, take it away for the second half of action.
All right, Marky Mark, thank you. And, of course, we are back here, about ready to start the second half, a 10-6 ball game, both teams back on the football field. And when you take a look at what we saw in the first half, Dave Hunter, a lot of yellow.
A lot of yellow, critical. Just put an arrow in the side of Southwest DeKalb with their penalties. Just really cost them. They had one right at the end of the half that did not give them a chance to get that ball in, although the Marist defensive back made an excellent play, as Trey pointed out. But, you know, the quickness of Southwest DeKalb has really shown up because they spread the field.
Starting the second half straight ahead here on GPB. We'll be right back.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is made possible in part by the following.
As leaders in our communities, Georgia's locally owned and operated electric membership corporations are proud to sponsor the Georgia High School Association and to help our student athletes become the leaders of tomorrow. Georgia's electric membership corporations, lighting the way.
As a strong, stable bank, we're always looking for opportunities to boost the vitality of our communities by supporting local events and finding financial solutions for our customers in all economic times. Regions is proud to be a partner with Georgia Public Broadcasting in building a better Georgia.
In 1920, Americans thought the party was over, but it was just getting started. Ken Burns reveals how lofty goals trumped common sense and good intentions led to disaster. Prohibition.
All right, back here at Marist, and of course the War Eagles out in front of the Southwest DeKalb Panthers by the count of 10-6. We take you through the first half. We take a look at the highlights of this football game early on, and take us through Trey Hunter. Trey McDaniel, I'm sorry.
24-yard field goal for Austin Harden, and then a great run here by Malik Wright. He wasn't quite able to get all the way down into the end zone because the kicker caught him, the 4-4 speed of Austin Harden. Then we see another great run here by Toran Davis and a little spin move here to get himself into the end zone for the lone touchdown, but it was a missed extra point on that one. And then the most curious call of the whole night, a fake punt out of your own end zone on fourth down and about 25 yards to go, and it set up Marist's touchdown pass here to Gray King. Does a great job getting open there and throwing the defense for a loop. And then the last play here, well, almost the last play here, was a halfback pass that Toran Davis decided to keep himself. He gets down the sideline. I'd like to see him try to get out of bounds and give himself a couple of cracks at the end zone, but instead they weren't able to score there because of the offensive penalty.
All right, our halftime stats sponsored by the Atlanta Falcons.
You see, Southwest DeKalb dominated the game with 139 yards rushing, 163 yards total. Had the one turnover, but those six penalties for 60 yards, and there was two others that weren't any yardage. Six first downs to two. Not a whole lot of sustained drives from either team. Southwest DeKalb has got to quit making those mistakes.
And you said bugaboos would kill you, and exactly, you know, the numbers don't lie, and you just brought that out, the fact that so many times opportunity after opportunity will slip away, and right now it's slipping away for Southwest DeKalb. Trey.
Gil, it's big play or nothing right now for Southwest DeKalb, and we've seen two long passes, really their only two completed passes of the night. Both of them were called back. Marist, on the other hand, as you saw right there, the numbers do not lie. They have not done anything on offense. That fake punt is just going to baffle me for the rest of the night and maybe the rest of the season. I really want to find out from Coach Godfrey whether that was a called fake punt or not. I just can't wrap my mind around that.
You know, when we talked early in the broadcast on the steps to success, one of the things Southwest DeKalb had to do was stop the mistakes. They have not done that. And also Marist must win on first down, and they have not really done that.
All right, those were Coach Hunter's step to success early on. Harden will kick off to Douglas and French. The ball will sail in the end zone. And Southwest DeKalb will take over first and 10 at their own 20.
Gil, if I'm Coach Buck Godfrey right now, we'll get to that in a second.
All right, let's go downstairs to John Nelson. John.
Trey, the mystery has been solved. I talked to Coach Godfrey about those mental mistakes. It was not a called fake punt. The play worked against Tucker, but they wanted him to kick it away. Same thing happened against Tucker, but this time it definitely did not work.
All right, thank you, John, for that explanation.
Question answered.
Trey.
John Nelson always on the spot. Like I was going to say quickly, Gil, if I was Coach Godfrey, I'd settle my bunch down here by getting to your bread and butter, and that's running the football.
All right, Young brings his troops up to the line of scrimmage.
First eye formation here tonight.
And, of course, a trail, 10-6. The Panthers of Southwest DeKalb. To give, straight ahead, stumbles a little bit, but goes forward is Malik Wright. He gets over the 20, up out to the 22. Coach Hunter.
Well, they came in the end over formation, which is where they threw those two passes earlier in the game, and they came with a counter tray to run out of that same formation. But I think you might see them come to that pass again because they did have a guy wide open.
Second and 8 for Southwest DeKalb at their own 22. 11:31 in the third quarter here at Marist on the campus of a beautiful campus in DeKalb County. We're glad you're with us here on GPB Football Friday. The pitch and the turn and nowhere to go for Southwest DeKalb. Looked like Malik Rowe was tied up.
Yeah, Malik Wright was able to find a seam here in the first quarter and make that long run we just showed the replay of. But this time, the talented tight or defensive end, Tabota, came up and made a great play, tackle for a loss. So now you've got third down and long for Southwest DeKalb.
Picture perfect tackle.
And as Trey said, Greg Tabota on the tackle. And that'll bring up a third and 9, a loss of a couple, and a ball at the 19. You see 28. Malik Wright is wide to the near side. And you see Young stats right now. Primarily, the Panthers are run team.
And more laundry on the field.
And whistles.
Dead ball. Delay of game on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Replay third down.
You know, this is the exact same spot on the field where we saw them commit their previous delay of game. And so they're not doing themselves any favors here because although it was third down and 12, now you're looking at a third down and almost 17 yards to go. You almost have to throw the ball here.
10:31.
They come in this spread formation again.
And it is a third and 15, Trey McDaniel on the 14, deep in their own hole. And again, whistles again. Flags.
That was the sophomore strong tackle, Kendall Baker, jumping into the neutral zone. So they'll pick up the 5 yards that they just lost, and they'll be right back where they started.
And I want to thank John Nelson again for giving us that explanation from Coach Godfrey.
Dead ball, encroachment on the defense, 5-yard penalty, replay third down.
On what happened?
I don't know about you. I feel better now. I mean, it was an inexplicable call, and I'm relieved to know that Coach Godfrey didn't do that, but he's got to get that straightened out if they've done this against their two biggest opponents this year in Tucker and Marist.
All right, they're in the shotgun. A fake give, and sack is Young, and a loss of about 4.
Big hit by Tabota again.
The fake give to Wright, and Tabota was there. Wright again,
take
a look at it.
See on the replay, Tabota is coming from the strong side linebacker and does not bite on the fake and makes an excellent play. Nice fake. Quarterback's going to keep the ball, but Tabota's not fooled. He has made a presence for himself on defense tonight.
You see a level of aggressiveness that you didn't see in the first and second quarter from the Marist defense, and now they're going to get the ball back in fairly good field position. This is kind of the way that the first half started.
Give an assist, too, to Kendall Baker, who was right there, too. Part of that. Punt taken by the upman and taking it up to the 25-yard line, Nick Carrier.
From a coach's point of view, Bill, the halftime is so critical because now you'll see the adjustments from each coach and the staff and what they're going to try to do to make sure neither team really had any great movement of the ball. Southwest DeKalb did when they spread it out and sprinted with it.
War Eagle football with a short field. First and 10 at the Southwest DeKalb 37. They lead in this football game, the Marist War Eagles, by the count of 10-6. Just the start of the third quarter. Miles Willis, the give straight ahead to Jason Morris, and the big tough back gets over the 35, close to the 30-yard line, about down to the 33.
Positive yardage on first down. It's what it's all about in this offense. They have yet to gain 4 yards, Coach, on first down, which is one of your steps to success. But I think they'll take 3.5 at this point.
Coach, you right on those steps of success. There.
You can see he's thrown the ball twice, one of two, and rushed 6 times for 15 yards, the quarterback Willis.
Jay, Coach, I'm on that step of success tonight, isn't he?
Always.
Second and 6 at the 33. Willis will keep it himself, gets over the 30-yard line, close to the 25. That'll be close to a first down, Coach.
Best series they've had in quite some time. You can see the quarterback, this is the triple option. The dive is taken by the defensive end, and he turns the ball up. They load the guy that's responsible for the quarterback, which lets the quarterback run free.
And it is first down for Marist at the SWD 26-yard line. Marist, the War Eagles out in front 10-6, 8:42 in the third quarter. Willis, the pitch to number 11, who loses the football for Marist.
Matthew Barker on the pitch, just a little in front of him. They do, Southwest DeKalb does a much better job of assignment football. And Toran Davis is on top of the quarterback. It was a pretty good pitch. It just didn't handle it.
Yeah, they had lined up their tight end, and they sent him on the pitch there, threw the defense off a little bit, and that's what happens in the triple option. We talked about timing at the top of the broadcast. If the timing's not right, those of you that watch Georgia Tech, you know that turnovers can easily ensue.
Right. A loss of big yard. It sets up a second and 20 at the 34. Willis fakes the pass, keeps it himself over the 35-yard line, about to the 33. Pickup of about 3.
You know, you might have a little different mindset because you've got Harden on the sideline. As a field goal puts you up 7.
Yep, and that's what we talked about when they missed the extra point. That extra point can always loom so large. And this game typically goes down to the wire, fellas. And when it does, when you have a field goal kicker that can kick a 59-yarder and you've got an opponent that's missed an extra point, I got to tell you, I like Marist's chances in that situation every time.
Well, it looks like we're headed to what we had last year, right down to the wire. And you look at Austin Harden right there, and he is automatic. Rolling out is Willis, 35. Puts it in the air, and the pass is complete over there on the sidelines. And it is William Curran. Let's listen in. Here's how it sounded. Pass is complete. Wow.
Very nice throw.
Coach
Very
Hunter, does, nice. That, does that remind you of the days when you were on the sidelines when you heard that, Trey? Huh?
Yeah. We all miss that.
Yeah, we do.
Now it's fourth and one.
Mm-hmm. Fourth and a long one.
We might get a freeze play here.
Yep, they might
used to call no play.
No play. You might try to draw them offside.
All right, take us through that. Explain it. What exactly what's going on?
You try to give them a quick count, a hard count, try to get them off sides. See if they'll jump. That's what they're doing.
And he didn't bite.
He didn't bite.
And you can tell, Gil and Coach, by the way, Coach, you know this, by the way, they scramble out of the huddle real quick and get up to the line of scrimmage. They're trying to have some little bit of panic and anxiety set in with the defense, but it didn't work there.
This used to be a pet play of mine, and they got so good at it, I finally talked my guards into asking the center so the defensive lineman would hear him, what's a snap count? That worked for a little while, too.
So they're going to take a timeout to talk about it, and I'm sure when they're going to gauge where, you know, what Miles Willis is able to see. And we take a look at the great programming here on GPB and Georgia Traveler. Buckle up for a new season of Georgia Traveler. Come along, our traveling team, as we hit the beach. Join the festival celebrations, discover unique museums, and tread upon Civil War battlefields. Catch them at their new times Sunday at 7 o'clock. On GPB, and I got a secret to tell you, all our folks out there on 790 The Zone and GPB, that's Dave Hunter's favorite show. Okay.
Oh, I love the mounds. I love Clayton. I've got a cousin.
He's always pulled up to the chair.
Yeah.
Watch it.
And the beach.
They're coming out, guys, in formation.
Right.
On fourth down. No Austin Harden on the field right now.
Fourth and one at the 17. Marist is going to go for it. The dive play. And the straight ahead. And that is Jason Morris. And he's close to the first down yardage, and they're not even going to bring the marker out.
Gil,
the signal,
Coach,
is the first down.
This tells you a lot about how Alan Chadwick feels about this football game.
Right.
He knows that he has not won this football game except for in one place, and that's the scoreboard right now.
And
he wants to try to, number one, keep Southwest DeKalb's offense on the field, number two, eat clock, number three, score.
There you have it.
They're going to measure. It's that close. I thought he had a
right.
I thought he was a little further along right there.
Looks like the spot, but, you know, it's like Trey just said, you know, burn up clock, chew up clock, and keep that football away from the explosive ability of the playmakers of Southwest DeKalb.
That's right. When I used to be on the sideline back in yesteryear.
No, come on now. You're not a relic coach.
I would holler at the officials. That's a right. Spot the ball on your right foot.
That's right. And I do believe he did not get a great spot on that. It's going to be very close. I don't know if he got it.
Right.
And Southwest DeKalb signals that he didn't. So Chadwick gambles. He doesn't win. And Southwest DeKalb has the ball. He had an opportunity there, Gil, to, with, like you said, Mr. Automatic, Austin Harden, to kick a field goal. And if he had, he'd have been up by seven.
Again,
it's a nice round football game.
Right. And another situation where Trey McDaniel says, huh, what?
You know. Well, you know what? I kind of like that call. You got to figure running the triple option, giving it to your fullback is going to at least yield you a yard and a half per.
How about Dave Hunter?
Per run.
Percentage.
I like the call, but I wouldn't be crazy about the spot.
Smoking like a true coach.
Yeah, that spot was questionable.
However, Southwest DeKalb, right, as we said earlier, any down.
Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 16. They trail by four, 10-6. Out of the shotgun is Jaleel Young. You see Young's numbers at the bottom of your screen. And the give right there to
that's the little guy, Xavier Johnson.
And Xavier Johnson gets over the 25-yard line, about to the 27-yard line.
You can see him come on the jet sweep again. This has been by far their best play. Excellent pulling by the guards on the offense, and then they get up inside. Ramel Crawford made an exit block outside, but the jet sweep has been far and away their best play.
The War Eagles, Jack Burke on the tackle. That'll bring second and two at the 25. 6-11 in the third quarter. Here at Hughes Spalding Stadium on the magnificent campus of Marist in the heart of DeKalb County. We're glad you can join us here on GPV and 790 The Zone. Young keeps it himself and gets over the 25 to about the 26-yard line.
I think he missed the handoff.
Yeah, I believe he did, because they crashed down on him. All four defensive linemen came through relatively untouched and collapsed on the quarterback there. I believe he was supposed to give that ball up inside to Toran Davis. Instead, he keeps it, and he's tackled by about eight dark blue shirts.
See, the guy was probably a little too far up in front of him. He couldn't reach him.
Exactly, and that was in the person of number 28, Malik Wright, who was a man in motion.
One thing I do like, fellas, is they're moving William Goodwin, Shaq, all over the field. He's been at tight end. He's been back at fullback. He's been out wide and in the slot so far tonight.
Marist talked about that yesterday in the walkthrough. Straight ahead. Try to get the first down.
It's going to be a close one as well.
Very close, Trey McDaniel. Very close.
Needed to get about a yard and a half, maybe two.
It's all going to depend on the spot. We saw the spot come into the spotting of the football coming into to play when Marist had the football. Official timeout, which means we're going to get some measurements, Coach Hunter. Get a look at Coach Godfrey in the Southwest DeKalb sideline.
We're on the opposite side, but I think he's a little short. Oh, they're going to say it's first down now.
They didn't even bring the chains out on the field to check. They just went ahead and awarded him the first down, much to the chagrin of the fans over here on the home side.
Coach Edwards is not very happy about that.
I wouldn't be either. Either way, first down, you see Goodlett, guys, in the slot at the top of the screen.
Big Shaq Goodwin.
Excuse me, Goodwin.
And Young is looking for the big fella. And it's incomplete. You called it, Trey McDaniel. You said he was in the slot, and they looked over the middle to find that big 6'8", 240-pound target.
Yeah, this time William Curran jumps in front of it and actually gets a piece of it, unlike what happened here in the second quarter. But, you know, you got a 6'8 tight end running out there at the slot. He's got an athletic right. edge on everybody in the defensive backfield. You get the ball to him at all costs.
Right, and you brought up the comparisons with him, Shaq, and the former University of Georgia standout Leonard Pope.
Reminds me a lot of Leonard Pope. May even be a little bit better athlete.
They're having a hard time getting lined up.
I know a lot of our friends down in Americas remember the play of Mr. Pope. And going to the University of Georgia in the NFL with the Cardinals and the Chiefs. Pass is complete from Young to Desmond Douglas, and that's over the 40-yard line. Or correct me, over the 30-yard line, up close to 35.
You can see he throws the quick slant in here to Desmond Douglas. And the Marist defender's right on top of the ball. The receiver, Douglas, makes an excellent catch because he was hit just as he caught the ball. For a nice 7-yard gain.
That 7-yard gain would chop it down to a 3rd and 4 at the 32, 4-11 and counting in a third quarter. The Panthers at Southwest DeKalb going from right to left. Wearing white tonight. Visiting white. Young gives on a handoff and the first man through over there.
That's another offense. It's third down and 4, and they ran the beer to the two-man side.
That was Clayton Davenport.
That was a big, big stop for the Marist defense.
It was a little puzzling because they've had such great success getting the ball in the alleys outside.
Stephon Waite will punt. And the ball taken by the up men for Marist. That's Nick Currier. And Marist will take over, leading in this football game, 10-6. We'll be right back after these very important messages on GPB and 790 The Zone. There's a new app. With that, with up-to-date, up-to-minute scores, full-season schedules, sports news, rankings, and so much more, our new app is the perfect way to keep up with all your favorite Georgia high school football teams for the entire season. Download the GPB Sports app, the football app on your iPhone or iPad today. That's mandatory. Trey McDaniel, do you have an iPhone app?
You're going to ask me that every week until I go out and get the iPhone.
I'm gonna go get it
just so I can have a different answer for you.
I want to see the
I'd love
evidence.
To have one.
I know Coach has an iPad.
Oh, yeah. Well,
no, we're going to start an effort, though, to get Coach on Facebook before the championship.
He has an iPad,
That's
too.
That's not going to happen.
We're going to do it.
He has an iPad, too. We'll get Coach social networking.
He's going to resist every step of the way, Gil, I'm telling you.
Willis throws in the slot and has his big receiver over there. That is David Phelps. And Phelps takes it over the cross midfield into Southwest DeKalb territory.
See, he throws it. This is called a quick hitch. And he throws it just out there. Nice throw. And Phelps makes a nice cut and gains 5 more yards after receiving the ball.
Not what you expect to see from a Marist offense on first down. Passing it through the air, one play, a first down. All of a sudden, you're inside Southwest DeKalb territory and you're cooking.
Mm-hmm. First and 10 at the 40. The pitch turning the corner. That's Greg King, 35, close to the 30-yard line.
And this is what we're used to seeing out of the War Eagle offense, getting the playmakers the ball in space, and they've done the job Good job with Gray King. He's not had that kind of space since the first quarter.
See, this is the play Georgia Tech's made famous with, that quick pitch. The guy goes in motion and stretches it and gets the pitch outside. It's a wide sweep that's done in a hurry. Excellent call and really a good cut. Gray King stuck his toe in the ground and cut it up inside.
That's two plays for 20 yards. That's exactly what Coach Chadwick wants.
Gain of 9. It'll make it 2nd and 1 at the 30. Man in motion is King. The fake pitch, the rollout is Willis over the 35. 30, 25, and pushed out of bounds, and flags on the play. It could be a late hit. Over there, Toran Davis appealing his case. Also, Justin Mincy.
And Mincy getting up very gingerly.
And Hector Stanbuck.
And what you see here, he fakes the pitch to King and he rolls out. He keeps looking back to his left, almost like he wanted to throw it to King, who was streaking down the hash there, but he didn't have it open, nor could he set his feet because he had the pressure. But he made a little something out of nothing, scoots out of bounds near the 20-yard line.
You can see the clip right here, right just as it was a clip on Marist called, blocking the back.
Preliminary
just as
signal.
He was going out of bounds.
Now confirmed, and the walk-off with a big penalty. Coach Hunter, you called it. And our great video at GPB confirmed it.
That's right. Those guys at GPB.
Back in the back. On the
showed
offense.
It to me.
10-yard penalty on the end of the run. Replay 2nd down.
You'd even need your glasses for that, Coach.
Yes, I did.
Guys, we're a minute 48 to go before the fourth quarter. It's been a stalemate here in the third quarter, partially because the team's defenses have done well and partially because we've got more penalties.
2nd and 3 at the 33, a minute 44 to go.
It wasn't a killer penalty, though, because they got a long first down and moved it back to make the 2nd and 3. Still can move the sticks.
All right, that's Willis. Willis in the slot and finds his receiver there. That's Gray King. He's an excellent receiver. And that's enough for the first down. King's still 20 yards.
See the play. Again, it looks like the option up inside, and then he gets in the seam. And they put the guy that's got the pitch in a real delicate, awkward situation. If he runs up the field of the pitch, they throw the pass behind him. If he doesn't go to the pitch, they'll start pitching it on the corner.
And it was great concentration by Gray King to catch that ball because Justin Mincy was coming at him with bad intentions and tried to rip his head off, but he was able to pick up the first down. As Coach said, a great down and distance there on 2nd and 3.
1st and 10 at the 22. The fake pitch. Willis looking. The intended receiver in the slot was Gray King again. About at the Southwest DeKalb 15, the pass is incomplete.
Coach made mention of the coaches going to the locker room and making adjustments. Looks like Chadwick saw something. Maybe they were cheating a little bit too much on the defensive side for Southwest DeKalb. He's come out throwing here, a little uncharacteristic in the third quarter for Marist.
Well, we got a guy open. He slips. The ball's a little behind him, and he slips, but he did have a guy open. They faked that, speed sweep again, or that quick pitch action. And then came off of that. Again, that puts the strong safety in a predicament because he's got to get up the field.
Willis. You see the man in motion is King. And the give is to 47, Jason Morris. And he's over the 20-yard line.
And that was just a straight wing tee play, dive forward to Jason Morris to try to pick up positive yardage.
Chewing up clock,
but you do have an unfavorable down and distance here with 3rd down and 8. But you are, like we said, well within Austin Harden's field goal range. And if he were to kick a field goal, we've mentioned it before, they'd be up by 7.
It was a kind of the triple option look. I think they thought they might catch Southwest DeKalb with their tackles a little wider and get the ball up inside.
Conrad Quinones, number 81, enters the ball game for Marist. 3rd and 8 at the 20. Full house backfield. It's going to be Willis on the keeper. 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, Marist! No flags.
Well, he's got some quickness now. Gracious sakes, he's got some quickness.
When in doubt, you need 3rd down and 8. You give it to your best ball carrier, the junior, Miles Willis. He goes in for his 5th touchdown of the year, and just like that, Marist extends their lead.
This is their play, the triple option. And they, you know, we said they've got to change up how they look. The guy that was responsible for the quarterback was blocked by the lead back, Barker, and the quarterback ran in and made a great cut to get it in.
That's the first time we've really seen Willis in the open field. He put quite a move on Justin Mincy, who's been all over the place tonight. Mincy over-pursued just a little bit. Willis, that's all he needed. He cut it up inside on a dime there for the touchdown.
Harden in for the extra point. It's up. It looks good. And it is good.
Barker loaded it. Barker loaded the end. You can see right here, Barker loaded the end, loaded the linebacker who had the quarterback, and the quarterback made a nice cut to get past the secondary man, Mincy.
You see the scoring drive on your screen, and we say it to you on 790 The Zone. Seven plays, 52 yards, the elapsed time, 2 minutes and 56 seconds, chews up a lot of clock. They score with 10 seconds to go, Coach and Trey, in the third quarter. 17-6, Marist, as we get ready to head to the fourth. You see the War Eagles schedule.
Let's take a look at the Marist schedule. They've got Carver away, Lakeside at home. That's a very winnable game. Then Dunwoody at home as well. Three out of the next four games at home. Guys, they're going to be done with the toughest part of their schedule after tonight. John Nelson right. set it up perfectly. This is all about seeding.
Right.
Both these teams will likely make the playoffs, but the winner of this game will have the leg up and they'll get a home playoff game.
There you go, Trey McDaniel. Coach, and Coach set it up too before with John Nelson. This game had playoff implications as we move forward. Coach,
they'll be heavily favored in every game the rest of the year.
That's why this game is so important for Alan Chadwick and company here tonight. 17-6 with a touchdown by Willis to put the War Eagles up. Harden kicks off, the ball deep in the end zone. Douglas will let it go out of bounds. And Southwest DeKalb will take over with 10 seconds to go here late third quarter. And they'll start the fourth. But you see the weapon there in 16.
I want you to look at 16. He's got some real quads. His lower body strength is amazing. Got great, great lower body strength. Coach Edwards was talking about that as well, but he runs so well. He's such a good athlete to be a kicker.
And a reset to tell you the story how Harden got here. His father was a DEA agent, drug enforcement. His family given 4 hours to get out of the country of Bolivia. And they came here, fed family in the area, Metro Atlanta. And Coach Chadwick got a gift.
He said, I'm glad he's here.
Young, looking over the right side, has a receiver over there, and that is Douglas. It is complete. He is over the 20-yard line, about to the 25, and that should be enough to end the third quarter. And it does. And we put up, Coach in the booth puts up four fingers. Trey puts up four fingers. Folks, we want you to put four fingers up. If you're driving in your car, don't you put four fingers up listening to our broadcast. But we are in the fourth quarter. Marist up by 11. We'll be right back.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is made possible in part by the following.
As a strong, stable bank, we're always looking for opportunities to boost the vitality of our communities by supporting local events and finding financial solutions for our customers in all economic times. Regions is proud to be a partner with Georgia Public Broadcasting in building a better Georgia.
The German Consulate General in Atlanta, encouraging you to study German and to learn more about our diverse culture with much to discover in 2011. More information about Germany as an environmental leader and other current topics on the web at germany.info/Atlanta.
And by the Mabel Reeder Foundation.
College football comes to GPB this October. Now, your home for high school football is also home to the Southern Conference. The Southern Conference comes to GPB this October.
You get a look at the Marist sidelines. Very happy right now. One quarter to go. They have this game pretty much in command right now. 17-6. And welcome these three great-looking guys here from Football Fridays here on GPB and 790 The Zone.
I'm not sure who you're looking at. You're looking at us, but you're saying
I said great-looking guys. I said great-looking guys. You
there's
and
only,
Coach.
There's only one of us with hair, and it's gray.
That's and true. Speaking of the man with hair, what about your steps to success, Coach?
Well,
you're dead on.
We've been close tonight, but don't count Southwest DeKalb out, because they can make it happen on any down. Their coach has been in this situation before. You won't see them panic.
And speaking of those, that team not panic is Southwest DeKalb, Panthers, and their coach, head coach Buck Godfrey, legendary coach. And his quarterback, Young, drops back, looks in the slot, has Douglas up to the 40. It's close to the 40, but is pushed back to about the 37-yard line.
Gil, I think we know who his favorite receiver is, and it's Douglas. He's trying to get the ball in his hands in space, and he's doing a good job. That one moved the chains.
That was an outstanding throw. Had some zip on that ball.
Very good zip. And that'll bring up a second and five at about the 37-yard line. Correct that. That'll be a first down for Southwest DeKalb. Trailing in this football game, 17-6, with a whole lot of time to go to work here in the fourth quarter.
A lot of personnel change. They're going to have to get this one off in a hurry.
Out of the shotgun is Young. Looking over the right side. The intended receiver over there is, again, Desmond Douglas, but it falls incomplete.
You can see nice job of pass blocking again by Southwest DeKalb, and the quarterback makes a nice throw. It's a little behind him, and he slips, but you can see the cushion that Marist defenders are giving him. They have a healthy respect for that speed.
Absolutely.
Of Southwest DeKalb.
Second and 10 at the 37, 11:25 in the final quarter here at Hugh Spalding Stadium on the campus of Marist. Wonderful, wonderful institution here in DeKalb County.
They're going to stop play. If nothing else on this drive, fellas, Southwest DeKalb needs to move the ball into Marist territory and flip field position, because Marist has started at or near the 50-yard line on almost every one of their possessions so far this evening.
The fake and over the middle. The pass is complete to Davis. He's at the 40-yard line, but he's pushed back.
We got some pressure then from the Marist linebacker with a
right.
They gave a blitz. You can see him coming right up the middle.
Pass is complete.
Linebacker 42 up the middle.
Okay. And we'll take forward progress. We'll put it at the 41. Third and 7.
Marist defenders doing a great job of gang tackling. That's what you have to do against this speed.
Young again in a passing situation. Looks over in the slot. Has a receiver there. And is John West Grant. They'll make it close to a first down, but it'll be short.
And Coach, you said it perfectly. They're doing a great job of, they're giving them a cushion. They'll give them 4 yards on that play, but they're not going to give them 10.
Right, they've done a good job of tackling. You made that point a minute ago. Not just gang tackling, but they've done a good job of tackling the whole night, particularly when it's been one-on-one.
Punt sails out of bounds. And Marist will take over first and 10 at the 25-yard line. GPB is the only station to broadcast the state high school championship games year after year. And we bring you live high school football every Friday night. Now it's your turn to score big with a small donation to GPB. Text GPB to 85944 to donate $10. And remember to reply yes to confirm your donation. Standard, data, and text message rates apply. A one-time charge of $10 will be added to your phone bill. Support these games and these great kids. We say thank you. That's Great King. with the football for Marist.
And guess who comes up and stuffs the run from his free safety position like he's done all night tonight? It's the junior, Justin Mincy. There's a reason why Coach Godfrey loves this kid. We've called his name about a dozen times. He's got a nose for the football.
Gain of one. It'll make it second and nine at the 26. 9:42 to go here in the fourth quarter.
They need to gain 5 to 6 yards on this play to keep that down and distance clock they like running.
See the numbers on your screen. Marist out in front by 11. Willis, the pitch to King, turns the corner, gets over the 40, over the 25, up to the 30-yard line. About to the 29.
You've heard of a shoestring tackle. That was an index finger tackle there by Toran Davis. Gray King could not get away. You thought he had him free, but he had him one finger by the jersey, and that was enough for him to wait for help and get him down to the ground.
That was the speed option. We could see that again. The speed option where the quarterback hops back and brings it down the line. And he had a seam, but Southwest DeKalb closed that seam quickly with their quickness.
Not the down and distance you want, third and six, if you're Alan Chadwick.
Third and five at the 30. 8:49 and counting. Marist leads by 11. Willis drops back. The pass is complete to Quinones. And Quinones takes it over the 35-yard line, about to the 37.
They're doing a great job of being able to throw the ball when they have to. I'd like to see them come out again, Gil, and do what they did on the previous possession and actually throw it on first down and really catch Southwest DeKalb on their heels. They're cheating up to play that run, and you can really take advantage of that with a little maybe a hitch and go or a stop and go route. Not sure if that's in Coach Chadwick's bag of tricks or not.
They got a penalty for blocking below the waist.
Number 21. Mr. Mincy is over there again. He's been all very active tonight.
You can see this.
Take a look at the replay.
See the running back come out of the backfield and block below the waist. That's an illegal block because he's got to be lined up within 3 yards of the line of scrimmage, and he's too deep for that. Mm-hmm. That was a correct call. They don't always call it.
Right.
Well, they've called it three times tonight, so the officials are on top of it tonight. They've all been legit.
I'm sure both coaches have reminded the officials about the things they think the other team does wrong. I would never have done that.
No, never, never. Your secret's safe with me, Coach. Yeah.
Third and a long 21 for Marist at their own 15. The give, the end around is King. William Curran, correct that. And he advances the ball close to the 20-yard line, but very short.
They're trying not to make a mistake and beat themselves with that call.
They tried a little bit of misdirection. They rolled the dice and see if it might work. All the motion went to the right side. They came back to the left, but it was all for naught. Curran couldn't get out into space. And it looks like just what we talked about a minute ago, field position battle might have been flipped, especially if Southwest DeKalb is able to get a return here.
All right, Harden will kick at his own 18 and back to receive for Southwest DeKalb are Douglas and French. Harden, the punt, high, end over end, will take a bounce, and it'll take a Southwest DeKalb bounce, and then a Marist bounce, and then back again. We are starting a big 3 weeks here at GPB with our schedule of games, and we got a dandy next week. Get ready for a huge TV matchup battle next week. Norcross and Mill Creek beginning at 8 o'clock on GPB and also the radio broadcast on 790 The Zone. It's going to be big. Norcross and Mill Creek right here at 8 o'clock on GPB and 790 The Zone. And after that, we got Lassiter taking on Walton. And then Hillgrove and McKeon.
That's the one I got my eye on.
You got your eye on
Hillgrove.
Nobody, I mean nobody, knows high school sports in the great state of Georgia than Trey McDaniel and Coach Dave Hunter and our own John Nelson. Young, under heavy pursuit and a sack and for loss at about the 40-yard line.
Coming in to make the sack was Brandon Young. They lined up Shaq in the slot again, and it looked like Jaleel Young wanted to get the ball to him, but he just couldn't escape Brandon Young. That was a big play for the Marist defense.
Comes off the back edge, unblocked. Marist found something in the film study, I'm sure, when they got in that formation that they could not protect the backside. Right. Quarterback pulled up and made himself a sitting duck.
Loss of five, and that'll make it a second and 15 at the 42. 6:51 and counting. Marist 17, Southwest DeKalb 6. You're joining us here on GPB and listening on our radio partner, our great radio partner, 790 The Zone. The pitch from Young. The running back straight ahead. That looks like it's Davis. He's close to the 45-yard line, short of the 45-yard line, about to the 44.
That sack killed him, Gil. And you see the pitch here to Toran Davis. He does a great job, has good vision, but there's just too many unblocked men in there for Marist. He's gang tackled once again. We keep belaboring the point a little bit, but the tackling has been phenomenal tonight for the War Eagles.
Excellent tackle right. By Austin Hicks, number 42. Great tackle again.
Trey McDaniel, you can't say it enough. Keep saying it. Third and 14. The ball at the 44. 6:03 and counting. The clock and ally right now. The Marist War Eagles.
Huge play.
Young, rolling right, looking, throws long. The intended receiver over there for Southwest DeKalb, number 10, was John Wells Grant. And he's nicknamed, they call him John Wilkes Booth. Yeah, you figure that out. That's what Coach Godfrey Call said. That's his nickname.
Staying away from that one.
I'm gonna let Coach handle that one. Yeah.
.543 counting down here. 17-16. The Panthers will have to punt. And the ball taken at about the 24-yard line by Nick Carrier. And Marist will take over first and 10, leading 17-6, 5:35 here in the fourth.
Guys, I'd be remiss if I didn't say what a great job that was just then by Marist. They give Southwest DeKalb the ball in great field position, and they stiffen up on defense, and now they got the ball back and time's on their side.
Coach Hunter, look at the standings.
You can see Miller Grove, Tucker, and Mays, and Lithonia. Excuse me, Miller Grove, Tucker, and Mays are undefeated, 3-0. Lithonia, 2-1. Southwest DeKalb and Marist 2-1. Marist soon to be 3-1, I think.
All right, that's only keeper. That's Willis over the 25 up to the 27. We'll reset in terms of the timeout situations right now. Southwest DeKalb, three timeouts remaining. Marist with two. The clock continues to wind down.
The secondary people are making an awful lot of tackles for the Southwest DeKalb team, and you know, if they wanted to throw the slant behind them, they could get a very quick score because the free safety is much too active in a run game.
Second and seven.
When they fake the ball up in there, you can see he's at the line of scrimmage in a hurry.
I think we're going to see a steady dose here of the quarterback, Miles Willis, just as long as Coach Chadwick can pick up positive yardage.
Willis on the dive, the first man through is Jason Morris. He advances the football, moves it up to about the 29-yard line, third and seven, and the clock continues to count down. 4:35 and counting here in the fourth quarter. Third and five for Marist at the 29. They lead in this football game 17-6 over Southwest DeKalb, the Panthers.
Watch out for the pitch here.
Willis under center, fakes the pitch, rolls to the right, gets over the 30, crosses the 30 up to about the 32.
It looked like they were going to come with that same play they scored on the touchdown, but Southwest DeKalb rolled their secondary up at the last minute.
And there was a lot of disruption in the backfield there by the junior linebacker Joshua Patrick, and he really disrupted that play, and Willis wasn't able to turn on his speed and make a cut like he did earlier on the touchdown.
They faked the ball up inside, and they wanted to throw it to 22 down the seam, but they rolled a safety over the top of him, and he had nothing.
Harden in the punt for the War Eagles.
Good choice by the quarterback. Not to force it.
At the Marist 18, and back to receive are French and Douglas for Southwest DeKalb. And we have a flag on the play. Oh, my goodness.
I think they're going to get a substitution penalty on Southwest DeKalb.
Is that an automatic first?
No, it's going to give them a first.
But the yardage will give them a first.
It's less than five.
Huge mistake.
Illegal substitution on the defense. 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Right.
The mistakes tonight are just going to – Coach Godfrey's going to lie awake tonight thinking about how different this game could have gone. He won the first half of this game soundly, and it's been kind of a stalemate here in the second half despite the score. Marist is winning tonight on smoke and mirrors and Southwest DeKalb mistakes.
Willis, the fake, keeps it himself, gets over the 40, close to the 45-yard line. And it's brought down over there.
That's what they want on first down.
Mm-hmm.
Got to win first down, and they just won it on that series. They did not win it on the last series.
Deshaun Brown.
Here's the penalty story again. Southwest DeKalb 8 for 70, Marist 5 for 40.
But Southwest DeKalb's have been untimely and costly.
Second
just like the last one.
Second and 4 at the 42. 2:54, under 3 minutes to go in this football game here on GPB and 790 The Zone. Marist leading Southwest DeKalb by 11, 17-6. Straight ahead for Marist is Jason Morris. Gets close to the 45-yard line, about to the 44. Get a shot at Marist head coach, Alan Chadwick. Still with that game face on so many years in the coaching profession.
They're just going to grind this clock down as far as they can before they get off these next few plays.
Southwest DeKalb, 3 timeouts remaining. Marist with 2. 2:16 as we approach the 2-minute mark. Willis under center, full house backfield. The give straight ahead again goes to Jason Morris, and he gets it close to midfield, about to the 47. That may be good enough for a first down. At least that's what Dave Hunter's saying in the booth. And it's confirmed on the field.
Cut. We're not going to see Alan Chadwick smile at all. But in the inside, he's smiling because he sees those gentlemen on the other side of the field walking. That's the chain gang. They're walking down the field, and they're moving the chains. That's exactly what he wants to see. The other thing he wants to see, all he has to do is look to his right. It's the scoreboard and the clock ticking down 148, 147, 146.
All right. You see it at the top of your screen. And here on 790 The Zone, it's 1:40 and counting. 17-6, Marist down in front of Southwest DeKalb. Willis, the fake give, will keep it himself over midfield. 40, 35, 30. He may go to the house. 20, 15, 10.
Ring it up,
touchdown, Marist!
53-yard touchdown run on the keeper by Miles Willis. All he had to do there was make one cut. It looked just like the touchdown run earlier.
It was except the same play.
Except he ran about 45 more yards than he did on the touchdown.
You can see the play. Again, they load the guy that's got the near back, loads the guy that's responsible for the quarterback, and he runs free. Great call. They knew who was assigned to the quarterback, and that back blocked him.
What did Coach say, Chadwick say, about Willis yesterday? He said Miles Willis is a leader on this football team. He gets better and better each week. And he has the ability, the great ability to run the offense we're doing here at Marist. We saw it front center. Extra point by Harden is no good. And that's a rarity. That's a rarity. But you know what? They put 6 on the board.
Coach,
the Marist War Eagles out in front of Southwest DeKalb. Minute 23 to go. 23-6. We'll be right back.
Football Fridays in Georgia is made possible by the GPB Sports Council and by viewers like you. Thank you.
Next time on Secrets of the Dead, a mysterious Roman island.
Bleak, desolate.
So rugged, few ships survived the voyage there.
5 shipwrecks are discovered within one contained area.
The Lost Ships of Rome on Secrets of the Dead.
Tuesday at 10 on GPB.
All right, 23-6. Marist out in front of Southwest DeKalb. Downstairs to the great John Nelson.
Thank you, Gil. Let's talk about Alan Chadwick. Alan Chadwick, one of 4 brothers that went to Decatur High School. He was the only one that went to the University of Georgia, ended up going to East Tennessee State. His senior year as quarterback, led the conference in yardage and total yardage, drafted by the Chicago Bears in 1974. But they drafted a quarterback in 1973, Gary Huff out of Florida State. So he kind of came down here. And he knew that Marist was going to be his place when he was an assistant coach under Dean Hargis. They lost a region championship game by 1 yard in penetration. He knew coaching was his thing, and he knew that his place was right here.
All right, from one historian to another, pick it up, Dave Hunter, from there.
Well, Alan Chadwick has been, Dean Hargis started it here, and I coached against Dean when I coached at Ridgeview, and I won't tell you when that was, but it was before Chadwick got here. But Alan Chadwick has just, he's made Marist a household name. What a great job they've done, and he plays within the confines of his players. That's what's so impressive. He doesn't ask them to do things they're not capable of doing, but he's very demanding that they do what he wants done exactly how he wants it done.
Very
so
well
he knows
said.
What he wants, right. How he wants it, and when he wants it.
Right now he got 23 points, and he needs another gift, folks, another great gift, like John Nelson, Dave Hunter, and Trey McDaniel, great people who are passionate about this great game of high school football in this great state of Georgia.
And I'll add on to what Coach just said. I loved hearing Coach Chadwick talk about his team yesterday. He says, we have a great product of kid here at Marist. They're focused, they're intelligent, and they're committed. And like Coach just said, he gets every ounce that he can possibly get out of these players, and they go lay it on the line for him every single Friday night.
And he's doing it you know, with decreased numbers too, Coach. I mean, a lot of kids have, you know, left the program.
He told me, Gil, that he had 16 players that should have been juniors or seniors this year that did not, that are not back with him. That is a huge number. Two of them are hurt, three of them moved. I think 8 to 9 of them chose another sport and not to play football. So football's a tough sport. It's hard to practice.
23-6, Southwest DeKalb trying to get back in it. The pass incomplete from Young to Douglas in the flat.
You know, he told us in the meeting yesterday that of those 16, 5 or 6 of those guys would probably be starters this year. So he's doing it anyway without all that. It's a very demanding academic, rigorous schedule here as well. So it takes a special kid.
Well, he said they're always doing something, whether it's lab or community work or doing stuff, and they make it all work. They make it all work.
This team here is a great testament year in and year out to what hard work and discipline will do. It can overcome the odds of being outmanned, outspeeded, outsized. It can make up for everything. When you play as a team and you cut down on the mistakes and you're committed to what you're doing and you're following your coaches, good things happen.
Young throwing it high up in the air, the intended receiver over there for the football for Southwest DeKalb was Jalen French, and the ball's incomplete. But, you know, let's talk about the great fans, the great support here at Marist. I mean, one of the most unbelievable sights I saw here tonight, the Southwest DeKalb High School Marching Band, the great Southwest DeKalb High School Marching Band went over and played in Pasadena at the Rose Bowl, giving a standing ovation by the Marist faithful here tonight. That was truly, truly classy. And just an unbelievable sight.
Phenomenal performance by their band, too. They mixed in a little bit of everything, a little Stevie Wonder.
Right.
It was fantastic. They really got this crowd riled up. They put on a fantastic show.
300
you
strong.
You talk about excellence. The Southwest DeKalb band is excellence personified.
Right. And the Southwest, the Panther Nation coming over here, watching their team play tonight, came here in mass. And we'll go away disappointed. Get a shot at the band, the world famous Southwest DeKalb High School marching band. Like I said, Mark Arman talked about it earlier. They went to Pasadena at the Rose Bowl and have a big banner that talked about and blew everybody away out on the West Coast from what I understand.
They probably hadn't seen anything like that.
Mm-hmm. Unbelievable. 32 ticks on this clock.
Something to see, something we take for granted here in the state of Georgia. Some phenomenal bands around here.
And as
Looks like we're going to get a punt.
Right.
And I'm sure Marist would just sit on the I'm sure they won't feel this ball.
Well, I don't want to disrespect Southwest DeKalb by going ahead and tying a ribbon around this game, but I got to say, the story of this football game, guys, has been the crucial penalties. Like Coach said, not just penalties in big situations. And what really turned this whole game around and gave Marist some hope was that fake punt, which Coach Godfrey did not call. John Nelson got us the story on that. They did not call that fake punt. His punter took it upon himself to bring it out of the end zone. And next thing you know, Marist is punching it in. They're taking the lead, and the rest is history.
Well said, Trey McDaniel. Well said to kind of put a bow on this game. And as an old friend of mine, Al McCoy, would say, this one was in the old deep freeze. Willis will.
It's all over. You know, we said early in the game in our steps of success that Southwest DeKalb had to, one of the things they had to do was stop the mistakes. They did not do that tonight. and they had to play disciplined on defense right. with assignment football. Two big plays cost them when they did not do that.
One of the great sights in high school football, you know, the two teams coming out to shake hands. You saw the disappointment on the face of Coach Buck Gottfried, and this one is over, folks. Marist has won it by the count of 23-6. Next week, we head to Norcross and, of course, Mill Creek.
Guys, win number 293 for the great coach, Alan Chadwick.
Yep. Big win. He should get to 300 this year.
See Coach Chadwick congratulating the Southwest DeKalb coaches and players on great sportsmanship.
And Marist now moves, gentlemen, to 12-6 in the all-time series versus Southwest DeKalb.
And pretty much control their destiny right now in this Region 6 Quad A.
They do have to play Lithonia on down the line, and Lithonia has a good ball club. They're 2-1 right now.
Look at that shot. That's right. One for the ages right there. And Godfrey doesn't look happy.
No, but
there's a little smile from
they'll
him.
Come back.
They'll be back.
They'll come back.
He's not going to sit down and let this one.
You don't see that every day.
Yeah, two winningest guys in DeKalb County history.
500-plus wins shaking hands there at midfield.
And if there's a Mount Rushmore in Metro Atlanta, those two would be on it in terms of coaching, along with Dave Hunter. You know,
how about that?
Let's go downstairs to our John Nelson, who's standing by with the great, great coach of Marist, Alan Chadwick.
Thank you, Gil. Here with the coach. Let's talk about halftime adjustments. Defensively, really aggressive and kept them on their heels.
Well, yeah, we tackled better. We stayed at home. We didn't over-pursue things. We kind of stayed at home and kept on our feet. We talked about staying up on our feet and running through the tackles and trying to grab more cloth and hold on, because they were doing a great job of slipping through tackles in the first half, and our kids came back and did a great job in the second half.
And then, obviously, you know, the run once again, Miles showing the effort at quarterback. He seems to be growing more and more into the position.
He is. And I'm real proud of him. You know, he's got some Southwest DeKalb background. His dad went to Southwest DeKalb and played for Coach Godfrey. So I know he wanted this one real bad, and he did a great job for us tonight.
All right, good luck tonight. Thanks for hanging out with us. We'll have some players in a second. I'll send it over to the best seat in the house, and Mark.
Thanks very much, Sean Nelson. The final score here, 23-6, Marist over Southwest DeKalb. The game is over, but the post-game show is just kicking off, and we're going to kick things off with the highlights from this football game. The Marist War Eagles, a winner, 23-6. They get a couple of touchdowns from Myron Willis, another one from Gray King. Let's take a look at the action that we have here at Hugh Spaulding Stadium. Right off the bat, it's Austin Harden booting a 24-yard field goal for Marist. Austin Harden kicked a 59-yarder last year. He's headed to Florida. It's 3-0. Then Southwest DeKalb's Toran Davis spinning his way 22 yards into the end zone. This made it 6-3. Southwest DeKalb on top. Marist quarterback Miles Willis hits Gray King. Makes it 10-6 at the half. Third quarter now. Myas Willis, the triple option. He takes it right up the middle, and he is gone for the touchdown, 17-6. And then late in this football game, it was Myas Willis with another long touchdown run. The triple option that Marist has run year after year after year. Number 12 scores, makes it 23-6. Your final score, that's how it wrapped up here at Hugh Spaulding Stadium. Another win for Coach Alan Chadwick. Now, let's send it live back to the midfield to John Nelson, who's got a couple of guests standing alongside. John?
Actually, I got a lot of guests standing alongside. I got a bunch of colors. I got guys dressed in blue, but I have Gray, I have Miles, and I have a kicker. All right, you, we talked a lot. Now, let's talk about your story. And obviously, you know, we talked about it here, you know, Austin. We talked about what it's been like for you to come from South America to here. Seriously, what's it been like for you ever since 10th grade?
Well, it's been pretty crazy, and kicking was something I got into 10th grade, and I ended up really enjoying it. And obviously, it's worked out for me, but you know, I really love football, and I ended up actually quitting soccer for it. But coming from where I was playing soccer in South America to never thinking I'd even be playing football to playing it for the next 4 years is just a dream of mine come true, and I'm really excited about it.
All right, don't go anywhere, because I need you to be the studio audience here as we talk to the quarterback. Miles, let's talk about what it was like for you to beat Southwest DeKalb and for the family to beat Southwest DeKalb. For those that don't know the story, we kind of went into it a little bit, but talk about the story.
It was a great win. You know, we had a great week of practice. It was really an emotional win for me because my father played for Buck Godfrey. So it was a great experience. I wanted to really go out and make him proud, make my team proud.
All right, we're going to talk to the folks up there because that's where the camera is, so don't move. All right, Austin, close ranks, will you? Come on. All right, Gray, let's talk about the game tonight. Obviously a big game against Southwest DeKalb. They're kind of a growing rivalry here, but talk about what the approach was coming into tonight.
Yes, sir. Well, like Miles said, we had a great week of practice, and
The whole game plan was just to be physical and
let's talk to the folks right there, the big red light. There we go.
The plan was to be physical and you know, not back down. We knew that they would come out and you know, hit us in the mouth, and it was just a great thing that our whole team fought back, and you know, we were physical the entire game.
All right, don't go anywhere. All right, let's keep talking about region rivals. You know, obviously tonight was a really big game. Talk about how this sets you guys up as we continue to go further down the line. Obviously tonight, Tucker, huge opponent, Southwest DeKalb, huge opponent. Now let's talk about the rest of the season real quick.
Well, we're getting through the first half of the season, which is the toughest with back-to-back strong games. Now it's all about staying focused and keeping our eyes on the prize. This game was big to get our place in real good place for second place in the region. So to come back and after losing a tough one to Tucker, taking care of Chambly, and now we came back and had a great physical game against Southwest, meant a lot.
All right, let's talk about it from the senior point of view. You know, you've been through this for a couple of years anyway. You've gotten kind of adjusted to things in Region 6. What's it like from your perspective?
Well, Region 6 is obviously, I think, one of the best regions in 4A, and it gives us a chance to come out here and compete every night. And, I mean, each year the games are exciting and come down the last minute, and we played really hard, and we're just focused on the next game on our schedule. And that's the most important game to us, and that's been our motto all year, and we want to win out and keep going.
I know that you want to get the touchback record. I know you've got one more, and I know you want to hit one from 60-plus. Austin, Miles, Gray, thanks for hanging out. Let's send it over to Mark Harmon in the best seat in the house.
John, thanks so much. Once again, Marist a winner tonight, 23-6 over Southwest DeKalb. For Marist coach Alan Chadwick, it's career victory number 293. We've told you all night long that tonight's